Think about this. The average first grader is 6 years old when the school year starts. 1 year to them feels like 1 million years does to the Grand Canyon. For both, it's 1/6 of their time on Earth. But when that first grader grows up and reaches 24 years old, 1 year is about 4% of their life. That's the same percentage as 1 hour to a mayfly, which lives for roughly 24 hours. To figure out how long a year is relative to any creature's existence, take the number 100 and divide it by the number of years that thing has lived. As things age, each trip around the sun becomes an ever-shrinking percentage of its lifetime. Take the oldest human ever. Jeanne Calment was 122 and a half years old when she died in 1997. She rubbed olive oil into her skin, ate 2 pounds of chocolate per week, and avoided stress when possible. But she also smoked. So who knows what her secret was? In this percentage of lifetime calculus, to Jeanne, each year was about 0.82% of her time on Earth. Believe it or not, that's a fairly high percentage when it comes to maximum lifespans. A giant tortoise can get up to 188 years old, so 1 year is only 0.53% of its life. 1 year to Greenland sharks, which have lived to be 392 years old, is a mere 0.26% of their existence. And some flora and fauna hang around for way longer than that. Quahog clams can live 507 years. The oldest bristlecone pine is 5,067 years old. And one meadow of seagrass has survived in the Western Mediterranean for 200,000 years. To them, a year is like the blink of an eye, respectively, 0.2%, 0.02%, and 0.0005% of a lifetime. 122 and a half years might not seem like a lot to, say, that ancient meadow of seagrass. But look at it another way. Time is relative.